Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot, and we are back playing Birthdays the Beginning. And today is an exciting episode because today is the day we get our first dinosaur. Our mission for today, our mission part two of the campaign, is to breed our very first dinosaur, to evolve our very first dinosaur. So, I think the first thing we have to do is to create a river. And I believe the river is... What's all this stuff? What's all this about? What are these orange bits? You know what? I don't have a bloody clue. So our goal is to start off with a river. You can see I've kind of gone around and sort of fixed this up a little bit. I've got rid of that big, tall, spooky mountain thing just because it looked rubbish. So let's go into the item menu and let's find river, just there. Creates a river source in a 3x3 section of flat land where you can... Okay, so I think I need to raise it up 3x3 before we can do that, right? Well, there's only one way to find out. So, let's make ourselves a river. So that's a 2x2, yeah? No, that's a 3x3. So that should be a river, right? If I click on that. Yeah, okay. Boom. Ah! Okay. I do. As the land around a river starts to soak, over time the land will turn green. This rule applies to both seas and rivers. It's one of the most basic rules of this world. Now, let's start making a river. Lower the neighbouring ground, just like I told you, be the two rivers are connected to the adjacent land, it's the same height or lower. Huh? Okay. Apparently I did it, it's fine. Also, if you expand the cursor and lower the adjacent terrain, the entirety of the cursor will create a river. Okay. I wanted to lead into my little lake, you know? Though new life will be birthed, naturally if you can create the right environment, certain conditions must be met in order to create a significant change in an ecosystem. If you run into trouble, it's my job to help you out. Oh yeah, you may have noticed already, but it takes a while for the sea temperature to change. If you change the temperature by moving the ground in micro mode, the sea temperature will gradually increase. For now, it goes to birth the sea organism Astraspis. Are you going to tell me how to do that? I just want to make my river look cool. There we go, look at that! Why not, eh? Why the hell not? Okay, I just want to mess around with this for a second. I want to put a block here. And then reduce that. Okay, that's pretty cool. Shut up, world. I mean, why is the water not coming on there? That's weird, right? Does the river basically, it can't stay still and become a lake. It has to like actively move downwards, I guess. I mean, I suppose that makes sense. Let's see if we can create a waterfall, maybe. Although I think it might be too low now. Okay, I don't know what I've done, but I've made a thing. Okay, all right. Let's go get some HP points. Oh no, not start. There we go. Look at that, my lovely little world. So, what do you need me to do here again? Conditions for Astraspis: water 41 degrees, a sea, and 276,000 picaea. We don't have that right now, but we will. So let's focus on getting the ocean to the right temperature. So I think what we're going to do for that is go... Ooh, what have I done? What have I done? Ah, okay, I know what I did. Is it still working? You can still hear me? Okay, good. I still want to keep the shallows just because we have several things that rely on the shallows. So I think what we do is we're going to just make an ocean. We've never made an ocean. They've always been shallows. So I guess what we need to do is make this and then... lower it down. So we need it to be pretty big, right? It's the sea. The sea is large. Well, we have a little bit of ocean. Let's tell you what, let's start time and then speed up time. We need more of these Picaea anyway, which are like, I'll show you them in a second. It's like a weird little cuttlefish looking thing. Let's just speed up time and see what happens. I've got 188k, 190k. Got Astroloxlion, which wasn't what I was looking for, but I'll take it. Picaea, 229k. How many do we need? Still don't have enough. Fast forward time. Oh my god, look at all this. It's actually... We did it! I'm actually managing to do things in the game. Remember the library? There's other information there besides what life forms you captured. Like, life forms you haven't birthed yet, but you've birthed but haven't captured yet. Or hints for life that hasn't been birthed yet. If you set it to view tree, you can even see how different organisms are connected. That's cool. Now we should try for Andriolopsis. But I want to go hop in first. Meet our new things. We've got two new creatures there, so... Oh, look at this. Like, proper life. Hello, little guy. What is it? Is it another type of trilobite? It looks like a trilobite. Oh, it's adorable! It's a jawless fish that swims through hot ocean waters. Oh, and we have love. That's good stuff. I want my little ocean to be... You know, I nearly finished my little ocean. We can't leave it sort of half done. Oh, I've got a bigger brush now as well. Oh, that's really cool. I'm going to mess around with the controls a little bit on my own time. Just get a bit more used to them. But... Between all this, we should have a new creature somewhere that we can go check out, right? We've got two new ones there, so what's the other one? Where are you, beautiful? I'm coming for you. I'm gonna find you. Or you will land. Ooh! Look at this! Oh, that's awesome. Ah, okay, it's a fern. Baragwanatha, that underwent a mutation and migrated to plains where water is scarce. Okay, now. Water 35 degrees, C, minimum 1 Astraspis. If there's one thing I don't really get, it's the temperature control. But it's working anyway, so... Whatever. Strong predators feed on weak prey, might sound cruel, that's blah blah. Without prey, predators cause fire, a lot of life born to be eaten. Environment is maintained, the whole system falls apart. The food chain has a very deep connection to life, there may be few predators to total all, but the over. Yeah, so. It's like the ratio of carnivores to herbivores in Africa is like 1 to 100 or 1 to 1,000 or something. I don't know, something like that. Coelocanthus! Oh, cool. That I like the idea of. First things first, let's go meet a new friend. Where's our new friend? What is our new friend? I actually don't know what he is. Gonna find you. Is it this? I think it's this, right? No, this just looks like a dying fern. Oh no, it's... Hello. What is it? Oh, it's little fishies! Andriolepsis, a small fish native to various sea habitats. This creature first appeared in the ocean when flora began to thrive on land. Like so. Okay. They did mention, you know, this thing. Oh. Library, that's what I've been looking for. Okay. How many creatures are in this game? So many! I've not got these yet, right? I haven't seen any of these, so. Ah, look at that! No! Dimetrodon. Look how much stuff there is! The final one is a reed bunting. That is a lot. I found 12 but captured 18. Like, I've not captured all these, seemingly. What's that one? Oh, Coelocanthus, that's what I'm working on. Coelocanthus. Okay, B, L, back. Why is L back? Whatever. Whatever. What do we need for Coelocanthus? Water 28 degrees. Deep sea. I don't have deep sea. Okay, we're gonna have to go deep in our water. Good thing we've got this big old brush. So how deep do we have to go for deep sea? Let's find out. Minus 11! Bloody hell. Why does that look different? Oh, it's just... Okay. Well, let's try that. Let's just give that a go, see if that works. Fast forward time. Well, let's start time. Boop! Get myself some HP, and then... Boop. Well, I got something new. It wasn't what I was looking for, but it's new. And there's our coelacanthus. Nice. I really don't understand the temperature thing, because maybe it was the right temperature. Who knows? Looks like it went well. I wonder what the birth of this life could mean. Just as plants migrated onto land over time, animals will too. Marine life will first evolve to be able to live on land and in water. This is believed to be the origins of amphibians. Check game info to find the conditions on how to birth Ichthyostega. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Shore temperature, 30 degrees, and we need lots of coelacanthus. Well, I want to go find... I got two new things there, so we need to scan both of them. Very beautiful. I know where a coelacanthus is, but I don't actually know what the other thing was. Where are you, cheeky little lemon? Okay, let's go get the coelacanth anyway. Should be in here, right? Look at it! Awesome! Okay, right. Yeah, what was the other thing? I don't think it I was hoping it maybe shows up on the mini-map. You know, it's a different colour, but it doesn't seem to, does it? Not that I can see, anyway. Can it see? Because there's... Ah, there it is! Just a pretty little flower. Right, well, that's a wee little plant thing. Dum da dum 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 da dum. Right, let's zoom out and speed up time until we get the coelacanth we need. Is the coelacanth going up? That's all I need. Oh no! Oh no, my coelacanths are extinct! Why? Okay, we've got more. And they're extinct again. Okay, my coelacanthus can't seem to get past 1500 or so. We did get two new creatures there, though. Oh no, my maybe there's I don't know what that's about. Maybe there's not enough food. Maybe... Oh, hello. Cool. Got loads of these things to collect. I think the little pink ones are meant to be ones you haven't captured yet, so that's worth keeping an eye out for. Right. Why is my coelacanthus dying? Is it because there's not enough water? It doesn't seem like that would be the case, but... Let's just make a little bit more just in case. What's temperature down here? 30. Wait, is temperature global? Is that what I've been doing wrong? No, because look. Deep sea is 30, shallows is 33, land is 36. Okay. Let's just give it a go, you know? Come on, coelacanthus, I believe in you. I'm getting lots of other stuff. Alright, there's my coelacanthus. Yes, it's going up for the first time. Yes, it's doing it. It's doing it. 8,000. 15,000, right. Oh my god. I didn't need much more than that, did I? Shore temperature 30. Coelacanthus. Right, we've got the coelacanthus we need, but I don't think the shore is the right temperature. Shore is currently 35. So that just means... The entire planet is too hot, right? So we can fix that though. We've got items that might help with that. How do I... F. You know what? We're just gonna give it a go and see if it works. Because that seems to be a good idea in general. Generally speaking, it's done pretty well for me. Blue Gramma. Oh no, my Heliophyllum. Oh, Raphia, we are going to lose stuff fast. Oh, well, it worked, right? Maybe I'm just going to ignore temperature. The noble amphibian bound to its watery domain until the day comes when it adapts to land and becomes a reptile. Life's a trip. What does evolution even mean? What's that meant to be? Will be? Is it all predetermined? Who knows, friendo? Oh, you're making sure to capture new organisms as they're birthed. No, I should focus on that a little bit more. Dimetrodon, this one I'm excited about. Okay, X. I want to change what the minimap displays to just uncapture stuff, which I think is what it's doing now. So, we've got these pink bits. A lot of them should disappear as I find this Myriopterus. A vine-like plant that grows at the roots of Lepidodendron and wraps around it. Yeah, so you can see lots of them disappeared, so we know we've got another one over here. Oh, what is that? Oh my god, it's my thingy! It's my little... My Ichthyus stick. Oh, look at it, it's adorable! Got loads of these things. Got some more stuff. There was actually one that I didn't capture despite... And that was, like, dead, so... Oops. A plant that thrives in warm, dry climates. It differentiated with the proliferation of that thing. There's one of those things here, but I just can't seem to get hold of it. Right, okay. Well, my world is looking lovely, I think you'll agree. I'm gonna add a bit more water, I think. I just wanna make something cool. I'll go back and... Right, okay, that'll do. I just want a little bit more life, you know? Right, let's zoom back out. Okay, so what do we need for Dimetrodon? Loads more Ichthyostega, so... I'm just gonna do what I always do and fast forward time and hope for the best. Got some calamite. Right, this time, when we get a new thing, I'm going straight in to capture it so they don't bloody die on me again. Right, calamites is over here. Ah, there it is. Oh, it's a lovely little tree. You aren't having a great time over there, are you, buddy? A tree that adapted to warm plains. It seems to be a differentiation from blue grammar. Oh, we leveled up. Let's get a good look at this dude, actually. Is it I? Oh, no, I pressed wrong button. Oh, whatever, who cares? Fast forward. Heliophyllum is now. Is this the one we had before and I didn't capture it in time so it died on me? Maybe. Where are you, buddy? A coral that lives among Cyclomedusa in warm shallows. Cool. Boop. And start time. Silophyton. They just keep bloody racking up, I tell you. Where is it? Where's my Silophyton? Okay, it's actually not on the map for some reason. Okay. Okay, I've got nothing for your Stega, but we're not getting Dimetrodon. Which suggests... Oh, there we go! Dimetrodon! The birth of dinosaurs is nearly here. They're pretty similar to reptiles, so you'll need to birth Eoraptor. It's a two-legged dinosaur that emerged after Dimetrodon when the climate got a lot hotter. It seems Eoraptor hunted in packs too. Sweet. Alright. Hello, love! Oh, they're so cute! Okay, let's go meet our new Dimetrodon, first of all. We've got a new... Is that new? No, something around here is new. Ah, there we go. Where's my Dimetrodon, eh? Over here. There it is. No. In the most awkward place possible is where it is. The first reptile that lives on land in cool climates. Unlike Ichthyostega, it moves to lands that have little water. Yes, clearly that's the case. Hey, buddy! Look at you floating around. What are you up to, eh? What are you up to? Ah, oh, this is cool. It looks really good as well. Like as all the plant life comes in, the whole thing just looks really nice. Yes. Okay, so I want the temperature to go up, and I've made this big-ass mountain. So let's knock this down. There we go. Yeah, it just went up by 1 degrees. Get down here, cheeky little lemon. This is my house. Okay, I'm gonna turn this corner into a deep ocean. Oh wait, no, I can do bigger than that, can't I? Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Bam. Boosh, 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 boosh. Little spider. There we go. That's a pretty. Oh no, little spider's in there. I'm sorry, buddy. Well, we need to get some time going again. Oh, Astraspis, no. Can't remember what you are, but no. Okay. Back in. I just want my first dinosaur. Our mission today is to get our first dinosaur. Right. So this should all be lowered as well, but I really like it, so I want to keep it. Temperature is now 30 degrees. So we've got a way to go yet. Let's make this nice and big. And, boo! There we go, just went up by another 1 degree. And another one. Good stuff. I think it's gone up to 35. Is that what that means? 37. 38. I'm so close, it's on 39! Nearly there though, nearly there. The birth of the Eoraptor. Don't know why I have to say it like that, but I did. My economy, it seems kind of stable right now. Nothing's really fluctuating too much in population. Which is cool, right? No, I'm so close. There we go, 40 degrees. Is the general temperature. So that should be fine. That should be enough to make this work, I think. If I finally got this down in terms of how this actually functions, that should be enough to birth an Eoraptor at some point. Right? Stegophyton, not what I'm looking for. There we go! Eoraptor! I've got this in the bag now, I've got this in the bag. The world of dinosaurs I always dreamed of. You can either capture it and return to your world, or you can enjoy this world a little longer. Where's my buddy? Oh, I've got some new stuff. I don't care about any of this. Where's my raptor? My raptor! Over here, over here, over here. Hooray! Finally! Blood, you know, that took ages. I don't even know what I hit. L, maybe? I feel like I've only been here a moment, and yet it also feels much longer. Just how much time has passed, really? It's too dark in here to make sense of things. I should go outside. I don't know why, but as I headed towards the exit, I had a hunch that something bad was about to happen. See? I knew it. Mr. Dinosaur, don't look at me like that. Who do you think created you, anyway? I ran back into the cave where I could say any of that. That is totally from Jurassic Park, right? Clever girl. Clearly I was in over my head. Right, let's see what we're going to be doing on the next one. A world is humongous. It doesn't actually feel nice to return to a world that's filled with dinosaurs. You don't know me at all, do you, game? I can't really give you the details. It seems this world and your world are linked, and you come from a world of humans. In short, if you manage to birth humans in this world, you might be able to return to your world. Recreate the age of dinosaurs, and the age of mammals will follow. Birth the ancestor of man, Australopithecus. Awesome. Okay, I just want to finish off the episode by seeing our little dinosaur. Okay, that's fine. Okay, I'll do that in a minute. We're going to use global warming, but we're not, because we're here to find... Look at that dimension over there, that's so cool. Where is my Eoraptor? There he is! And V? V, I did it! I did a thing. And then the sun. Hi, buddy! How you doing? Our very first dinosaur. One of many, I'm sure. You get that, pal. Nom nom nom. Awesome. Awesome. Oh, I can turn the UIF. Didn't know that until just now. He's so cute! Okay, right, I'll stop now. V. The only problem I have with this, right, if we zoom out, look how big that world is, and I have to, like, expand my world into that world to make it look all nice and pretty. That's a lot of time. Yeah, so next episode, if we do come back, we're going to use global warming and try to birth the full-on age of the dinosaurs. That means T-Rexes and sauropods and ceratopsids and just loads of cool new stuff. Hopefully we can see some stuff we haven't seen before as well. Thank you very much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I shall see you lovely folks in that next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.